Let's now have a look at the process about how you cr actually create these templates. And to show you this, you come into the Meta portal to the WhatsApp Manager section within there. Within the WhatsApp Manager on the left, you've got a template section, and we'll start by looking at the templates library. So this is where you can see a number of pre-built templates for authentication and utility as inspiration and as a kind of quick way to get you started. This is also a good example of where I said the features vary depending on the template type. So if you choose an authentication template, one of the settings you get given is how do you want to deliver that code when it lands on the handset? And there's a number of options that you can choose there. That feature wouldn't apply to the other template types. If we continue, I could go back and also look at the utility messages. We can filter for different types. And again, you'll see a number of different ways that Meta recommend to use. I actually want to send a marketing message, so I'm going to come into my template library and click create. Here we then get to choose, am I looking to create marketing, utility, or authentication message? And so you can see what those look like, reminder of when to use them. Within marketing, you've got three sub-options: custom, which will be the vast majority of templates you send out. Catalog can be used more for a kind of e-commerce use case, so having an actual catalog of products on WhatsApp that people can use and buy, and the flows feature that I mentioned. So let's choose custom and come into the builder. First thing, we need to give it a name, choose the language that we want to send it, and those will be used as the identifiers later when we come to reference this template within the Messente API. Next, we can give it a header. There's a few different options for that. You could give it a big bold title. You could put image, video content on. You could also use documents or even locations as the sort of header content to put on. I'm going to choose an image. You don't need to define the exact image up front, but they do want a sample for the approval process. So within the API, we'll actually define the image that we want to use, but you've got to give them just an example to show them the sort of thing that you're going to use. Next, we'll carry on to the body section. And here's, I'll paste in some content I've got. So promoting WhatsApp business messaging with Messente with some features that I want users to understand. I could also put in a little footer comment there. So this is looking quite good, but now I'd like to personalize it a little bit. So rather than just saying hi, I'd like to include people's names. So here's where we can use variables. So I've added a variable. We get a little placeholder text that I'm going to put where I want the variable to show. And just like with the image, we've got to give Meta a sample so they understand how we're going to use that. So I'm going to use it for names to make it feel a bit more personalized. Then we've got an offer. And I'm sad to say this is not a real offer. This is just for demonstration purposes, although I'm sure our salespeople are feeling very generous at the moment. But here's where we could personalize again and maybe give people different offers depending on their relationship with us. So I could use a placeholder for that as well. Next, we're going to include some buttons. So lots of options for different types of button you can include. There are quick reply buttons, which are ways of having a pre-canned response. So when they click the button, it'll load a response in and the user can just hit send. Meta will recommend you use that for as an opt-out technique. So if you choose that, it'll give us a button with button text, stop promotions, and you can then when the user taps that, it'll then send a message like that to your user. Now, you don't have to use that. You could also use a web link button as another way of managing opt-out. So here I'm going to use a visit website button, give it the text, unsubscribe. I'm going to paste in a URL to my unsubscribe link so that this time when they click that, it'll then open up a web page with the unsubscribe page in it. Then I want to add a couple more. So maybe another website button to show the user where to go and find out more. So we've got them interested in my engaging content. Let's give them a website to go and find out more information. And also, if they really want to get straight onto us, talk to our sales team, they can have a phone button as well. So talk to us. I'm going to put in the phone number and the country code, and that button would then be configured. Once we've inputted all that information, we're happy with what the template looks like, give it a good check over. We can then submit that for review. The review process, Meta warned, can take up to 24 hours. In our experience, it hasn't taken anything like that. It's been more like a few minutes. It seems to be highly automated. And as long as, you know, the content isn't being flagged for any reason, you know, probably infringing with the business policy we mentioned, it's very likely to be approved very, very quickly. Your experience may vary. So, you know, we should warn you that they do say it could take up to 24 hours. The other limitation around reviews is if you want to make changes to a template, you are restricted about how many templates you can make a day. So it's one or two changes, and after that, it'll be locked until the next day. So if you are making changes, try and make sure you get them all done first time and don't forget anything. Otherwise, you might have to wait a little while before you can send those again. Final thought I'd say on the template builder is the tool is very guided. It takes you through and shows you exactly what is allowed, what isn't allowed. The options are pretty clear. So we found building templates has been quite an easy process. It's very quick to add them and get them approved and ready to use. So really, I wouldn't see this as a barrier, but start playing with it and you'll quickly get familiar with it and understand how that works.